Well, and I think that the dangerous, you know, edges here are that he's trying to undermine the media, trying to make up his own facts. And it could be that while unemployment and the economy worsens, he could have undermined the messaging so much that he can actually control exactly what people think. And that is our job.
Yeah.
Okay, here we are. And which Republican candidate has the best chance of winning the general election?
Of the declared ones right now, Donald Trump.
There's not going to be a President Donald Trump. That's not going to happen.
Not going to be president. He is not. Donald Trump is not going to be president of the United States. Take it to the bank.
Okay.
I guarantee it.
All right. All right.
And then, of course, there's Donald Trump. Donald Trump has been saying that he will run for president as a Republican, which is surprising since I just assumed he was running as a joke.
Do it. Do it. Look at me. Do it. I will personally write you a campaign check now on behalf of this country, which does not want you to be president, but which badly wants you to run.
And so, right now, Mr. Trump, to answer your call for political honesty, I just want to say, you're not going to be president, all right? It's been fun. It's been great. There is zero chance we'll be seeing you being sworn in on the Capitol steps with your hand on a giant golden Bible.
That he can actually control exactly what people think. And that is our job.
Yeah.
Could I just cut through? I have one thing to say, one thing only. And that is that this race is over. Tomorrow morning, the money will dry up. The Republicans will start to hide. Trump has no place to go. This race, effectively, as of tonight, is no longer a presidential race. As far as Donald Trump's concerned, it will never, ever, ever happen.
President Obama will go down as perhaps the worst president in the history of the United States! Exclamation point. At real Donald Trump. Well, at real Donald Trump, at least I will go down as a president.
And that is our job.
Yeah.
You say that Donald Trump has the best day in the entire world, completely outperforms expectations, and he wins all of the toss-up states. He wins all five of those states, plus that electoral college vote in Maine that he's after. If he wins all of the toss-ups, which would be insane because nobody wins all of the toss-up states, even if Donald Trump did win all of the toss-up states, he would still lose.
That he can actually control exactly what people think. And that is our job.
Yeah.
What if we're seeing something else, something deeper, a more permanent separation between Clinton and Trump? Could we be seeing our first true landslide in a long time, a double-digit landslide? That is Clinton's lead in four polls now. What are these five gray states? These are basically Rust Belt states. These are industrial Midwest states that Donald Trump thinks he can flip. They were blue states in 2012. If you look at Trump's strategy, if you look at the blue-collar voters he's going after, these are the kinds of states he thinks he can flip and get to 270. So the first question is, how is he doing in these states that are the most promising for him to flip, at least in his strategy? So let's take a look. First of all, we have a poll out of Pennsylvania. This is a brand new poll. This came out a couple hours ago. NBC News, Marist. Well, look at this. A double-digit lead for Hillary Clinton in Pennsylvania. Hardly the first double-digit lead for Hillary Clinton in Pennsylvania. This is the third one we've seen in a week for her. So Donald Trump, Pennsylvania is a big target, but all the evidence we have right now says Pennsylvania is still favored to be a Democratic state.
Megan, huge news. Actually, the AP now projecting that Donald Trump has won the state of Pennsylvania.
That is the race, frankly. There is no path forward for Hillary Clinton.
That he can actually control exactly what people think. And that is our job.
Yeah.
The Clinton campaign believed until 9 o'clock that they had a lock on this, that they were going to win. The fault of that actually lies with the media.